Kappa, it's Michado. If I look and sound and act dead or tired, it's because it's true, girl. It's because it's actually true. But anyways, I went to Trader Joe's tonight. Honestly, I just meant in my brain, I was like, oh, I'm just gonna pick up some vegetables. Because it's like really all that I'm in dire need of, like, and water. But did I get water? No. But I did get some vegetables and a whole bunch of other stuff that I probably don't need, but at some point I'm gonna need, because I eat every single day. So at some point I probably am gonna need to buy food again, and I already bought, so what is even this video? Okay, P.S. Do you like my, Dance the Magic t-shirt? Oh, excuse me. Dance the Magic. Yeah, so this year the color scheme for the performers, white and green. I have another one that I got from the first year. It's the exact same design, except it's red and white. And it's not this simple t-shirt cut. It's more like a, what do you call it? I don't even know how you call it, but it's over there. And the one last year was actually red and white as well. And it was the same kind of style. I don't even know, but yeah. Already missing it. Cool. Have you guys clicked out of this video by now? That's great. Okay, anyways. So, yes. Okay. I got these organic sweet potatoes. And honestly, I probably didn't need to buy this many. But, like, the ones that they sold individually were not organic. And, like, I'm about that organic life. You feel me? So, I don't really know. But I plan on, like, cutting these up and putting them in my slow-cooked vegetables as one of my root vegetables. Or, you know, you could also make sweet potato fries. Oh, my God. I could make sweet potato fries. And also, I could, like, bake it and, like, put maple syrup in there. Like, for, like, a sweet potato. Also, my friend just bought me this, like, vegan marshmallow whipped cream stuff that's actually sweetened with, brown rice syrup. So yeah, you could do endless possibilities. You can make a sweet potato pie. I could make a sweet potato pie. Okay, anyways, then I got some organic Gala apples, and these are so good. I mean, how can you go wrong with an apple as a snack? Like, literally, rinse it off, put it in your bag, eat it. Perfect snack. Okay. I got some honey wheat hamburger buns. Because honestly, the main way that I eat these is literally, I pour some sesame oil, some soy sauce or tamari, toast it. Eat it. It's like such a good, you know, kind of little snack, or even just like an extra little thing to eat with your meal if you're like so hungry. It's like basically like toast. So, and sometimes I even put tahini, like the plain tahini paste, on it too. Like after I toast it with the sesame seed oil and the soy sauce. So good. Okay, cool, my receipt. I got the receipts. Okay, then I got these sweet potato chips, you guys. I got these last time, and they were gone within 24 hours. They're so freaking good. They're just, kind of want to eat them now. But I know once I start eating them, I won't stop. So why did you get them again, girl? Honestly, because I've just been in a snacky mood. I've just been like chips. chips, you're gonna see. Chips. Chips on chips on chips on chips. I mean. Anyways, okay. Ooh, then I got this. Everyone keeps telling me about this. It's the Ezekiel Cinnamon Raisin Bread. And I just never got it. I don't know. I just never got it. But, like, everyone keeps telling me, oh, it's so good, so good. And, so, yeah, so I just got it. And the great thing, I made sure to check that this doesn't have any cane sugar, you know, white sugar in there. Which you guys know, I'm not about that life. You feel me? Where's it? The ingredients. Yeah. It's sweetened with malted barley, organic malted barley. And the salt that it does have is sea salt. So this is the thing. You want to stay away from, like, pure table salt, like, straight up salt. You want to stay away from that. But, you know, sea salt is acceptable in, you know, small amounts, you know. Table salt is acceptable in small amounts too, but it's just like, it's so extreme, you know. So you're going to go through extreme things when you eat something extreme, you know. But anyways, then I got these roasted unsalted sunflower seeds, because I thought this would be a good little thing to put in my cereal, oatmeal, smoothies. Cool. It's like a different kind of seed, a different kind of nut I can, you know, add to my routine. Because it's not good to eat the same stuff all the freaking time, even though sometimes I still do eat the same stuff all the freaking time. Okay. Anyway, so I got these organic black beans, and I think I got the organic... I thought I grabbed the organic kidney beans. They might be in another bag. And then I got this organic pumpkin... to make my homemade pumpkin spice lattes and maybe some other pumpkin kind of things. Maybe we can make like a pumpkin pie maybe, or pumpkin bread, or like a mixture, like with some, because I never really finish a can. I kind of use like a few tablespoons and then it just sits in my fridge and then it goes bad. Sorry, I just always have to pick my ear. It's like my OCD habit. Like, every single day, I just have to do it till the next day. But anyways, yeah, or I can, like, mix some of this with some, like, sweet potato, and I can make, like, a sweet potato pumpkin pie. That'd be so good, right? Cool. Then, oh my god, I wanted to tell you guys about this. Okay, these I bought last time. It's the organic chia bars, and they have almonds, cranberries, and pumpkin seeds. 5 grams of whole grain per serving. Can I even talk? They honestly taste like Rice Krispie treats. At least that's what they remind me of. They literally, they're so freaking good. And these are great. The only thing, you know, that's not so great is the cranberries are actually sweetened with sugar. But it's like such a small amount that I feel like it's fine. It's fine. But these are really good. So if you're wondering what kind of bar should I get, Trader Joe's, you guys should get this, and I think it's like $3.99, something like that. There's 5 bars in there. You know, little bars like that are also so great to, you know, have a portable snack. You feel me? Then these, you guys. Oh my god, I was so freaking obsessed. Okay, last weekend, and I told myself, Michelle, don't buy those again. Because you're going to go crazy. But I was like, no, girl, I have to. These are so freaking good. It's a multi-seed rice cracker with tamari soy sauce. These are bomb. So freaking good. They're so crispy. The taste is, like, so satisfying. The only thing, they do have dried cane. It does have dried cane syrup in here, which is basically sugar. And that's part of the reason, that's why I didn't want to buy them again, because, like, I am really trying to stay away from sugar, like. But, these are just so freaking good. They're so freaking good. Honestly, that tiny amount of sugar that's in here is probably not the biggest deal, but it's, like, still, I'm, like, trying to get away from that, you know. Progress, not perfection, girl. But anyways, then... Okay, then I got this organic marinara sauce because this is something I was reminded of pretty recently. I used to make my homemade pizzas all the freaking time at when I lived in my parents' house. Trader Joe's sells pizza dough crust. They've been selling that for a long time, ever since I was in high school, because that's when I would mostly make them. And my mom just reminded me that I used to do that recently, and I was like, oh my God, I should do that again, especially since now, you know, we have an oven that works. So I was like, yes. So I got some whole wheat pizza dough, which I'll show you in a minute, and my marinara sauce to make my homemade pizza. Oh my God. Then I got this organic peanut butter. It's crunchy and it's salted because honestly, okay, one of my viewers and friends on Instagram, she reminded me of the Laura Scudder's peanut butter, which I was so obsessed with it, and it's so good. It's probably like the best peanut butter I've ever had. It's like an organic, natural kind of peanut butter. But they only sell it at certain stores, and they don't sell it at Trader Joe's, obviously. So, I just kind of went with the next best thing. This is pretty similar to it. And this, it's salted with sea salt. So, again, that's a better option than just like pure salt. You feel me? Cool. Then, oh, and then also they had this thing at Trader Joe's, kind of by where you guys know, if you've ever been to Trader Joe's, they kind of have a little like box area. I guess it's like their customer service or whatever. And on that area, they had these little shelves that were like our vegan options, our kosher options, our, I think it said gluten free. Yeah, gluten free options. So basically, I grabbed two of them. Dietary list, that's what it is. So I grabbed the vegan one, and basically it just has a list of all their vegan items at Trader Joe's. And then I grabbed the kosher one because, you know, I'm not claiming I know everything, but from what little I do know, probably someone out there can better educate me, or I could further educate my own self. You know, kosher is the way that Jewish people eat, and it's a whole thing. It's a whole thing. P.S. So far, I have gotten one request to make like T-shirts that say it's a whole thing. So, which I think that's a good thing because I always say it's a whole thing. But anyways, yeah, such a thing. Okay, so basically, there's different levels. I forget what the name of it is called, but basically, there's different levels of consciousness while you're eating. I think there's seven levels. And my friend was, you know, he always tries to explain it to me, and sometimes, I mean, when he's explaining it to me, I understand, but like to retell it, sometimes it's harder. But basically, one of the levels of, you know, eating, of consciousness while you're eating, is like a religious level. And you know, macrobiotic eating, it's so like, I tell you guys all the freaking time, it encompasses a lot of things. Okay, so, you know, food is just not, it's not, it's more than just like, oh, it's here, let me eat it. I mean, some people eat like that. And it's more than a diet, but you know, some people eat that like that. But there's a reason why certain religions eat the way that they eat. And different religions have a different kind of little, you know, guidelines for, you know, how they eat. And there's a reason beyond, there's such a bigger reason why they eat that way. It's like, you know, and I think that's a great thing. I think that's so awesome. You know, no matter what religion you believe in, if you don't believe in any, it doesn't matter. I just think that it's cool that certain religions, they have, you know, kind of a dietary guideline, you know, to kind of help them, you know. And it's not, in my mind, I don't think it's just to help them in their religion. I feel like it helps them in so many more ways. So I don't know. I just really think it's cool. And definitely some of what, the kosher dietary, guidelines are, I think are awesome. And I would like to, incorporate into my own way of eating, So that's why I got this, because I thought that was really cool, So I'm not Jewish, like, girl, no, I'm not, but I just think it's a cool thing to at least educate myself about and maybe make my own kind of decisions based off of that. Because from what little that I do know, I think it's a good idea and it makes sense. So, anyways, yeah, okay, cool. Okay, then I got some organic broccoli florets, same old, shredded cabbage, same old. I got this organic arugula, honestly, because I always get the same leafy greens. I always get the power of the greens, honestly, because it's my favorite. And I was like, okay, Michelle, try to get something different this time, okay? Just try. Okay. So I got this organic arugula, honestly, just because I never really buy arugula. Like, if I'm gonna buy like a pure, not a mix, I usually get, baby kale or regular kale or baby spinach. I'm like, I never really get arugula, so I'll just get it. The only thing, arugula does have a very strong taste, and that might be a little bit. I can just kind of foresee that maybe I shouldn't have gotten this, because I can already. I know myself. I just do me. I guess I know myself. Yeah. So I don't know. Okay, this I showed in my last Trader Joe's haul, and I was like, it's good. I don't know if I would buy it again. Girl, what? Okay. I tried it in the video and I was like, oh yeah, it's fine. But then I took it with me, I think the next night, or I'm not really sure, to my dance team rehearsal, and I was eating like this these sweet potato chips, and that has salt in it, like, a small amount of salt. So of course I was gonna be craving like something cold and sweet, yin. That's all it is. Everything is a balance. You eat something yang, you're just gonna crave something yin. You do something yang, you're just gonna want to do something yin. You know? Yin and yang does not just apply to food, okay? Yin and yang applies to everything. And that's like a principle of macrobiotic eating. It's like, it's just not about the food. You do stuff that's yang. You want it. It motivates you to do something yin. It's just everything's a balance. So anyways, this was so freaking good. It's so good. It's like, basically, it's like orange juice, but it has a little bit, but like it has a little bit of taste of like cinnamon. I don't know, it's weird. It sounds weird, but it's actually so good. It has blood orange, persimmon, apple, sweet potato, ginger, and cinnamon. Did I really say cinnamon? I don't really know, but it's good. You should at least try it. It's so good. Then I got this new one that I was like, oh, this seems cool. It's strawberry chia 100% juice smoothie, a strawberry puree flavored blend with apple juice and chia seeds. So, yes, it just has apple juice, strawberry puree, chia seeds. That's it. So, I don't know. I just thought that would be a cool little fruit drink I could try with, some chia in there to have a little bit of protein. And of course, my trusty almond vanilla spice chai vegan drink. Just everything. Just everything. Love you guys, okay? Love them. Then my other thing, you guys know, cold pressed apple juice, the best. The best, the queen. Okay, then, oh, here's the whole wheat pizza dough. They have different ones. They have whole wheat, they just have regular white crust, And then they have a garlic and herb one, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, I just got the whole wheat one. I actually have never tried the other ones. Honestly, because when I was making my own little pizzas, I was like deep in my eating disorder. So yeah, I would just never touch anything that was. I never touch any food that was white, honestly. Except for when I binge, then I basically ate every white food ever. That's how it works. You restrict and restrict and restrict. It creates a yang, stressful, tight, compacted state. And you can't do anything to satisfy, you know? You just at some point get so tight, so yang, you're just gonna go crazy. And that's what I did. I went crazy and I ate a whole bunch of sugary stuff, all of the things I told myself I couldn't eat, and I would binge on it. So it's like it's better just to have a balance, you feel me? Instead of trying to be so this way, because at some point this is not gonna work anymore. You're gonna go that way. So anyways, then I got this organic frozen corn because I love mixing this with like soy chorizo and making like vegan tacos. But also I like to eat this as my grain, like when I make those corn green chili cheese tamales. I'm trying to say it the proper way. Instead of trying to be a poser white girl, because guess what? I'm both a white girl and I'm both a Latina, so I gotta find a balance. You feel me? I'm not one or the other, I'm both, so I need to create my own balance. How to say stuff, you feel me? Anyways, yeah, so instead of eating rice with my tamale, eat some corn because corn is a grain, it's a whole grain. Also, let me just tell you something. So sometimes when you poop, okay, you see corn in your poop if you ate corn. Honestly, because you need to chew your food, girl. Grain doesn't digest once you swallow it. Corn, the way that grain digests is with your saliva when you chew it. That's why it's very important to chew your food. Because otherwise, you're just swallowing whole corn kernels. Your body's going through all this work. Your body's working so hard, and at the end, you didn't get anything from it except work your body, not in a good way. So that's why if you see corn kernels in your poop, it's because you need to chew your food, girl. Okay, then edamame hummus. I got two of them because I was like I just go through them so fast. I try not to eat them, but look how small. If you're just sitting there snacking with some, oh my God, I ate these. I love to eat these with the Hava chips. You guys know those corn chips are bomb. Or I was eating them with, where is it? Oh, sorry, Minnie. I was eating them with these. Deadly combination. So freaking good. Sorry. Okay. Anyways, oh, that's the end of that bag. And one more bag. Okay. Multicolored carrots, duh, girl. Green onions, duh, girl. Oh, I got this organic celery because, you guys, what has been wrong with me? I've just been craving celery, like celery with peanut butter. I've been like craving it. Anyways, then I got. Ooh, I got this vegan shredded mozzarella style cheese when I make my homemade pizza. Because honestly, call me crazy, I actually love vegan cheese. I never had this one before, so hopefully it doesn't taste weird. But all the other vegan pizzas that I've tried, I liked their cheese, or I've grown to like their cheese, you feel me? So. Then I got some shiitake mushrooms. These are just great. These are just with shoyu or soy sauce or tamari with green onions and all the vegetables cooking together slowly. And it's just so perfect. So freaking good. Oh, and then I saw these today. Oh my God. Okay. Ugh. You guys know I love those frozen tamales at Trader Joe's. You guys know I love those. And yesterday, or the other day when I was at Sprouts, I saw that they sold vegan tamales at Sprouts. And I was like, maybe I'll try those next time. And then when I was in the section that had, I found these authentic Mexican style handmade vegetarian tamales with cheese and green salsa. Even more. And they also had, I think they had one with some kind of meat in there. But I was like, because now that I actually tried a tamale that I like, I'm like obsessed now and I can't have enough. So I was just like, ooh, okay. So I'm gonna try these. They're probably gonna be bomb. Okay, oh. Then one almost last thing. I got this Indian kind of thing. I don't even know, honestly. I was honestly hungry when I went to Trader Joe's today, but I just got this alu chaat kati pouches. I don't even know if I'm saying it right. It's a crispy pastry stuffed with potatoes, chickpeas, chaat masala, tamarind chutney. I don't really know, but it looked kind of good and I was so hungry, so I just bought it. And it's something that you just freeze, and then whenever you want to eat it, you put in the toaster oven or whatever, the oven. I don't really know, but I was like, oh, that looks different and kind of good. Let me just buy it. It has no meat in there. Yeah, it's vegetarian, so it's probably gonna be so spicy. But something to make really quick when I have no time to cook, you know? Oh, and the last thing I got is just red kidney beans, because whole food makes you a whole person. Makes your mind whole, makes your everything whole. It makes this a whole thing. It's a whole thing. Whole. Oh my God, how perfect. Minnie, stop. Come here. Look, all the haters want to say hey. All the haters want to hate. Right, Minnie? The haters just want to hate. I mean, can you blame them? Look at you. Anyways, see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Later, haters.